Welcome back for another Power Pack Training. This is Maurice Gear. Today we're going to talk about how many cold calls you should be making. This is a question that I get from a lot of people. How many cold calls should I be making? Well, ladies and gentlemen, you guys all know that sales is comprised upon knowing your numbers and your ratios, okay? And if you really look at it mathematically, it all boils down to an equation. Okay, sales is all about an equation. That meaning that if you put forth X amount of activity, you're going to get X amount of result. Okay, so if you wanted to make 10 sales in a month, you would have to talk to X amount of people, set X amount of appointment, and close X amount of individuals. Okay, you can mathematically systematize your numbers, okay, to get an end result, okay? And I'm going to show you guys pretty much how to do that. I'm going to show you how to basically, just based upon a few numbers, you can literally create a six-figure income. So I want you guys to stay to the end of this training. It's going to be absolutely mind-blowing and exciting. And if you're in social media marketing, this is an excellent training to just let you know what's possible when you pick that phone up and you start making dials. There's something magical that happens when you make phone calls. So the first thing, folks, when you start to make calls, you have to know your numbers, okay? And if you watched any of my videos, I always tell you to keep track of how many people you call, how many people you speak with, and how many people tell you yes or no. Okay, those are the three important equations, okay? Because once you know those three things, you know how many calls you need to make to hit your goal, okay? So you have to know your numbers. Just don't get on the phone and just do that brrr, shotgun effect, you know, and just make calls randomly. You don't know how many people you've talked to, how many people told you yes. You're just setting appointments, okay? You have to get in the habit of knowing your numbers. Like, I know my numbers. I know if I get on the phone and I talk to five people, all right? If I talk to five people, I already know I'm going to get two to three. Those are my numbers, okay? Even if I'm having a bad day, if I talk to five, I'm going to still get one or two, you know. But like I said before, I know my numbers. So if I wanted to book, let's say, 10 appointments a week, then, ladies and gentlemen, I know I need to be talking to five people a day. That way I'll get one or two people a day. That's it. So I know my numbers. So the reason why most people are frustrated with cold calling and why they say it doesn't work is they don't know their numbers, okay? How do you know your numbers? By picking up the phone and starting to make dials, okay? So let me give you this example. If you talk to 20 people and you get two people to say yes, okay, then you have a 10% ratio, all right? So you talk to 20 and you get two. So ladies and gentlemen, if you did that, multiply times five, you talk to 20 people a day, okay, that gives you two yeses, all right? So every 20 people you talk to gives you two. So if you wanted to set those 10 appointments a week, you need to be talking to 20 people a day, okay? Now, if you're brand new on the phone, let's say it may take you 30. So you need to be talking to 30 people a day, okay, to get two, or to get one, or to get three, or to get five, you know, depending upon how many appointments you're trying to book, all right, or how many appointments you're trying to see, or how many demos you're trying to email out, okay? This is so important. You have to know your numbers, all right? Because when you know your numbers, ladies and gentlemen, you can get rich. Let me say that again. When you know your numbers, you can get rich. See, when you know your numbers, you know mathematically, when I come home from work or before I go to work, I'm going to kiss the wife, kiss the husband, kiss the kids, eat dinner, and I'm going to go into my room, lock the door, and I'm going to grab me a lead list or find some leads, and I'm going to start making dials, and I'm going to do it consistently, because if I do it consistently, I'm going to get a result, okay? So to get three people to say yes, you need to talk to 30 people, all right? So if those were your ratios, all right, this is the amount of individuals you would need to communicate with on a day-to-day basis. Now, you might have to call 50 people or 60 people to get in contact with 30 people, all right, to get you your three people, okay? So there really is no set number of calls you need to make per se per day. But I will say this, if you want to get good on the phone, you're going to need to talk to about 500 to 600 people. Okay. Let me say that again. If you're brand new, you've never made cold calls before. Okay. You're going to need to talk to a minimum of 500 to 600 people. Once you talk to about 500 to 600 people, ladies and gentlemen, and in the process of doing that, you're going to build a thick skin. What people say to you is just going to rub off. You're not going to be affected by people saying they're not interested or don't call me again or I'm not interested, Charlie, or whatever the case may be, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to be equipped, okay, and you're going to be indoctrinated with the cold calling swag, we like to say, okay? You want that cold calling swag. You're brand new. You need to talk to about 500 to 600 people. All right, because you're going to go through some things. You're going to see some things. You're going to hear some things. It's going to build your confidence. OK, it's going to make you who you need to be in order to be successful over the phone. All right. So just mark that down. If you're brand new, you never make calls, you're going to need to talk to about 500 to 600 people. All right. And you can do that over the course of a month easily. All right. And if you talk to 500 to 600 people, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to start to get very good at this thing. Now, I'm going to give you a secret. The more calls that you make, OK, it's going to improve your ratio. OK, let me say that again. You can improve your ratio by making more calls and getting better on the phone. All right. That's very, very important. All right. So the more calls that I made, it actually improved my ratios. When you improve your ratios, it allows you to make less calls, okay? So let's say I make calls. This is what people do. They make calls sporadically, and they never improve their ratio. So they always got to talk to 30 people, okay? They always got to keep talking to 30 people to get three. But if you improve your ratio, all right, you could talk to 30, and now you can get six. So you move your ratio from 10% to 20% because you got better on the phone. See, when you get better, things get better. Write that down. If you want your finances to get better, you have to improve your skills. Your skills have to get better, okay? So many people want to make $100,000, but they got crappy skills. If you want to make six figures, you got to have a six-figure phone etiquette, okay? You have to be able to get your skills to match the income that you want. Now, if you only want to make $1,000, then you don't have to get good on the phone. You can have crappy skills and still skip and make $1,000 a month easily, okay? But if you want to make the big money, I'm talking six, multiple six, maybe seven figures, then ladies and gentlemen, you got to get good at this stuff. You have to improve your skills. I don't care what you're doing. Your skill set will reflect your income. Write that down. Your skill set will reflect your income. Let's just take a professional sport, for instance. Why is it that LeBron James makes, you know, $100 and some million contract, but you have a guy, let's just say, you know, that's playing along with LeBron James, let's say like Lonzo Ball, he's only making, you know, $20 million or $5 million because of skills. LeBron's skills is better than that Lonzo Ball. Let's take golf, for instance, okay? Why is it that Tiger Woods has made hundreds of millions of dollars in golf, but yet other golfers never even began to make a six-figure or a couple million dollars in golf because of the skill set? There's a ratio in skill set. And so it's the same thing with you. If you want to make Tiger Woods money in social media marketing, ladies and gentlemen, you have to perfect your skills. And it takes time. Even if it took you 6 months, folks, 7 months, big deal. People work 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They work decades at a job and never make $10,000 a month, you know, and I'm talking outside of a college education. I was able to do this, make a multiple six figures outside of college. So, ladies and gentlemen, don't tell me that, you know, education makes you money. No, skills, as that slogan says, skills pays the bills, baby, because it really does. It's all about your skill set. So the better you get, the better your money gets. The better you get, the better your money gets. That's why I always recommend that you guys invest in training. Okay, it's good to watch YouTube videos and stuff like that and sign up for free courses and all that, but it's nothing like having some skin in the game, investing in a program that can help you make more money. Okay, that you want to invest in a program that can help you make more money, or invest in coaches and mentors, because if you do that, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to allow you to hit your goals much faster. Okay, that's important. So you should be booking a minimum of 2 to 3 appointments per day. All right. Let me say that again. You should be booking a minimum of 2 to 3 appointments per day. All right. That's minimum. So most of you guys, if you're brand new, you're going to be doing about 10%. You know, I don't really see you, even the worst person. If you get my scripts and my rebuttals, and if you guys haven't signed up for my social media prospecting pro course, click the link in the description. It'll give you guys everything you need to make money in social media marketing, and help you guys to crush it over the phone. All right. I think it's comprised of about 7 to 8 video modules, along with all the scripts and the rebuttals and all the tools you need to make it a reality and make a bunch of money in social media marketing using a phone. Another thing I like about making cold calls, ladies and gentlemen, versus, you know, let's say if you were to start an internet marketing business or a Shopify or Amazon business, is that the skill set that's required, it has a low learning curve, okay? Because everything that you get involved with, ladies and gentlemen, it has a learning curve. So if I look at all three of those business models, like let's say you were to get into real estate has a high learning curve. You have to know all the jargon and, you know, comps and all the things you have to, the paperwork, the contracts, the value of the home, what it's appraised for. Most people can't go from the streets to making $100,000 in real estate their first year. But in social media marketing, because the skill set is, the learning curve is so low, meaning that you could just get in it and just start making calls and get good at it within 60 days, 90 days, it's unprecedented, okay? It's one of the fastest ways to quit your job, pay your debt off, and to start making some six-figure money. You know, you can go from where you're at now and in 90 days be making six figures like that. Name another business that you can get in. And here's another killer part. With less than $100, you could be doing this for less than $100, you know. And that's why I did a challenge. If you guys on my YouTube channel, you watching this video, I did a 30-day challenge. This just show you how easy it is to get a $1,000 client. Okay, you could do this stuff, folks. But it's all about, you know, your willpower, your goals, your determination, getting over your fears. A lot of you guys have fears of making cold calls. And if you do, I often say, make sure you get a mentor or coach, you know, to help you break that mess, because that's going to hold you back, ladies and gentlemen. If you have fears of the phone and you're just afraid, you need a coach. Just hire a coach. He will help you to break that, to set your business up, set your goals up to get you to the next level. And a lot of you guys have been on this same level. You're not making a minimum of you should be making a minimum of $5,000 a month right now. If you're not making a minimum of $5,000 a month, it's two reasons, okay? One, you're not taking action. Two, you're procrastinating. And three, you need a coach. You need to hire you a coach, all right? You should be making a minimum of $5,000 a month right now, ladies and gentlemen, if you know about social media marketing. There's no excuses. The market is just wide open. Okay, that's a six-figure business at a 10% closing ratio. So if you had just a minimum of a 10% closing ratio, ladies and gentlemen, and based on the numbers that I just gave you, okay, you should be making a minimum of six figures, okay? And let me prove it to you. That's 60 appointments basically a month, you know, at a minimum of 10%. Okay, that gives you six sales a month, just six sales a month. Let's say you book 60 appointments and you only close 10% of those people, just 10%. And that's very small. That's very small. Matter of fact, let me dumb this thing all the way down. Okay, let's say you only close 5%. That gives you half. That's three. So if you did three sales at a minimum of $1,000 a month, right? That's $3,000 a month. Let's say you do it for 90 days. Okay, 90 days, you have $9,000. 9,000 times 12, ladies and gentlemen, that's $108,000. That's a six-figure income based on a 10% ratio. That's why I encourage you guys to make calls and to make them persistently and consistently. That's a six-figure business. A six-figure business. All you're doing is setting appointments with business owners getting better. Okay? So, folks, the more the story, get on the phone and make some calls. It's the fastest way to six figures. Think about that. How many of you guys want to make six figures? Grab my course if you haven't already. And if you have and you're watching this video, start devouring it. Go through it. Get some leads. Go on YouTube. Go on Yelp and grab some business owners that you can talk to and make some dials and get good at it. Set a schedule up. In other words, when you get off work, this is your hours of operation, okay? Or before you go to work, or while you're driving to work. You can make calls while you drive. I used to do it all the time and book appointments. Maybe I'll do a training and show you guys live how I book appointments in the car. Just no excuses. You have no excuse, ladies and gentlemen, this year to begin making six figures off this video alone. This video alone should put 100K in your pocket just for me showing you simple numbers. Now watch this. What if you took the 30-day challenge, all right, which I recommend you do, and grab the course, okay, because it's going to help you invest in yourself. You're worth it, all right? You're worth a few measly $100, okay? I should be charging more than that, but I want to help as many people as I can make $100,000. But watch this. What if you did take the 30-day challenge and you got good at this? And let's say you got really good at this. Instead of having a 10% ratio, you start closing 25%, okay? Because those are like my numbers, 25, 30, 40%, okay? So watch this. So now that's 60. Let's say you were able to close 25% of those people. Now it's 15. How would you like to be closing 15 people a month at $1,000 a piece? That's $15,000, ladies and gentlemen, a month that you can be closing in business if you got good at this. What if you did 30%? What if you got your numbers to 30%? You're setting 60 appointments and you're closing 30%. Okay, so 60 times 30%. So that's 18. That's $18,000 a month. Okay, you could get your numbers so well that you could be closing 50 if you consume the right books and trainings and courses and all that. Ladies and gentlemen, you can close so many people because you're increasing your skill set. How do I know this true? Number one, off myself. But let's go back to the equation that I gave you earlier about the people that's in the NBA. Why is it that the ones at the top get the max contracts and the ones in the middle and at the bottom don't get max contracts? You know, Lonzo Ball ain't getting no max contract. Why? Because his skill set is not where LeBron James' skill set is at. See, LeBron James makes 100 times or 90% more than most NBA players will ever make. Yet they make millions. He just makes 90% more. Why? Because his skill set is 90% better than everybody else. He's more valuable. His skill set is at a high level, and it's the same thing for you guys. If you want to make professional income, you have to be willing to get mentors, coaching, take action, apply what you learn, and get better at the game. That's it in a nutshell, ladies and gentlemen. I just gave you a blueprint to literally put 100K in your pocket, and I challenge you to go put it in your pocket, and that's the training. Maurice Gear, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.